A six-figure payout for hitting a pothole has councils hitting the panic button, claiming the negligence battle between an injured motorcyclist and ratepayers sets a precedent that could ultimately end up costing every Queenslander.
Potholes, big and small, are the bane of drivers everywhere. Southeast Queenslanders lodging 2,300 complaints through reporting app SnapSendSolve this year, a 34% jump.
Councils are very responsive to SnapSendSolve reports. It allows you to report issues in the community before, you know, potentially people can get injured.
But a pothole caused by flood damage is costing a rural council big. North of Gundawindi on the Leichhardt Highway, local woman Paula Tate was riding her motorcycle with six others when they came across the large pothole about a metre long and 20 centimetres wide. One rider became airborne on her bike while Miss Tate was catapulted through the air. A warning sign installed by council days earlier had blown over. Gundawindi Council ordered to pay more than $300,000 in damages.
The decision could create a financial pothole for councils across the state. With millions of kilometres of roads to maintain, many are considering lowering speed limits, even putting up permanent warning signs to try and protect ratepayers from liability.
Well, this is a really major issue for all of Queensland.
The local government association calling for the legal hole to be filled.
To mirror the New South Wales Act, which gives specific protections to councils going about their ordinary business of opening and closing roads and managing roads through a flood period.
But Maurice Blackburn's Greg Spinder says councils have clear obligations.
The reality is they've got motorists' lives in their hands. It's absolutely critical that they take steps immediately, reasonable precautions to ensure that those potholes or other defects are fixed.
Nick Kelly, Nine News.